Hello friends, welcome back to HSA English classes. Today we are going to learn the poem A Prayer for My Daughter by W.B. Yeats. Previous year question from this poem. Name the poetic collection in which A Prayer for My Daughter was published in 1921. Answer: Michael Robarts and the Dancer. The poem was composed in 1919 and appeared in 1921 in the collection Michael Robarts and the Dancer. It was written during the World War I, though the war ended, but Ireland was still on disturbance. William Butler Yeats' daughter Anne was born that time, and the poet was worried for her future. Let us study the summary of the poem. A Prayer for My Daughter opens with the image of the child sleeping in a cradle amidst the howling storm outside. The storm howling symbolizes destruction mentioned by the poet in his The Second Coming. He walked in prayer for his daughter to be protected from the physical storm outside and the political storm brewing across Ireland. The onomatopoeia word scream and the flooded stream symbolize the poet's overwhelming anxiety for his daughter. Also, it refers to the great flood in the Bible. Excessive beauty has always been a source of trouble and destruction. The Helen in Greek mythology, considered to be the most beautiful woman on earth, brought the doom upon her. And Aphrodite, who rose out of the spray, and their stupid decisions which brings them misery forever. The rich horn of plenty is suggestive of courtesy, aristocracy, and ceremony. That's what poet needs in his daughter. He wants her to become a flourishing hidden tree and her thoughts like a linnet, and he wants her to live like a laurel. The poet reflects upon his emotional state when Montgomery rejected him to marry John McBride. He wants his daughter to experience neither the disappointment nor hatred. An ideal woman makes everyone happy and comfortable. She is a stronghold for people around her, and her will would be that of heavens, for she has a clear mind. The poet expresses his final wish that his daughter to be married to a good husband who takes her to a home with aristocratic values and traditions. Now let us study the literary devices used in the poem. Personification. The storm is howling. Symbols. Storm symbolizes outside forces, cradlehood, innocence and infancy. Wind symbolizes turbulent forces, and one bare hill maybe of Robert's death. Metonym used in this poem. The author may be mistaken, but Atlantic may be the USA. Metaphor. Crazy salad. An inferior spouse. Paradox. Murderous innocence of the sea. Thank you.